Hello guys, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today we are going to talk about A-frame. Okay, so let's begin the video. This is A-frame which has been mounted above the transverse girder, and above it entablature is provided. Now let's see first what is the material of A-frame. Material of A-frame used is 0.3% carbon steel, as same as been used in the transverse girder. Means basically the transverse girder and the A-frame is of same material. Now where it is fitted, A-frame is erected over each transverse girder with the plate joining the frame together to form a enclosed space. Means above each transverse girder this A-frame is erected, and a separate enclosed space is been formed between for individual cylinder unit. Okay, for individual unit the space is been separated with the help of the A-frame. Why it is called A-frame? It is called A-frame because of its structural resemblance with the A letter. As you can see, this looks like a A. Therefore, it is called A-frame. Okay. Now, we will see why, what is the different construction method used for building the A-frame. Now, in this diagram, as you can see, this is the frame box construction. Okay. Why it is called frame box construction and where it is used, let's see. In modern engine, A-frame is fabricated in a single piece or a more pieces and then bolted together. Now what happened? The A-frame structure is fully made with a casting method. For a smaller engine, and for a smaller engine, the full unit of A-frame is been made in a single casting method. And if the engine is big enough, in that case what will happen? Suppose the engine is big enough, in that case 2 or 3 units will be made in a single cast, and 2 and 3 units will be made in other cast, and both will be bolted together. Okay, so what are the advantage of A-frame? The advantage of frame box construction are more rigid structure. Means the structure which is formed by frame box. Means why it is called frame box? Because of its shape of a frame. Means okay, so the frame box construction provide rigid structure, fewer welded joint, and hence development of oil leak is lesser. Now what happened? As the whole structure is fully casted, and therefore the welding job is reduced, and hence development of crack and oil leaks is less. Moreover, lightweight, good strength because of continuous structure. Okay, less cost, improved accessibility to crankcase and corset. Now as you can see that because it is made in a single unit, therefore the structural strength, means continuous grain flow, will be there, and hence the structural strength will be good one. And moreover, as making separate part and welding it together proved to be a more costliest job compared to the constructing in a single unit. Okay, in older engine what we used to have, means as you can see, in older engine this crosshead arrangement was not made within the A-frame. The crosshead guide arrangement was bolted to the A-frame structure, and it is been adjusted, the clearance is been adjusted by providing a seam. Okay, so this structure, as you can see, this is been installed, and here the seam are inserted. Okay, cast iron guide was bolted to the frame. Adjustment to this guide are carried out by seam to maintain the alignment. But in modern engine what we are doing, in modern engine the guide are machined in place and not adjustable by nature. Means what is happening, this guide is provided during the construction, and therefore we don't need to have a seam for adjustment as it is provided beforehand. Okay, and therefore it is not bolted, it is in machine structure. Okay, now we will see the A-frame fitting to bed plate. The A-frame, basically what happened, as you can see, this is the A-frame. Okay, this is a transverse girder. So the A-frame is been fitted to the bed plate by the help of fitted bolt and also by the tie bolt. Okay, now the fitted bolt is holding these two parts together, but tie bolt is holding the A-frame, bed plate and entablature three thing together. Okay, in compression. Now as you can see, that this is the hole. Okay, this is the hole which need to be drilled both in the A-frame and also in the trans bed plate. But this hole to be drilled in such a way that these two should match each other. To ensure the perfect alignment, what we are doing, the bolt hole on the bed plate and lower flange of the A-frame are drilled underside. Means what we are doing, we are drilling the hole underside, and after bringing it on the bed plate, the A-frame when bought on the bed plate, after that it is been matched, and then the hole are reamed to the correct size for passing the tie bolt. After both are bought in position, hole are reamed out and aligned after holding both component with fitted bolt. Means what we are doing, as the hole are drilled underside, and after matching the bed plate and A-frame with the help of the fitted bolt, means when they are met aligned, after that the hole in both A-frame and bed plate are reamed correctly so that the tie bolt can be passed together. Okay, now as you can see, this is a red joining paste from the oil tight seal between the A-frame and bed plate. This red joining paste is been provided over the transverse girder, and now the A-frame will be installed, and this red joining paste will be acting as an oil tight seal between the two component. Okay, now let's see what are the crack which can occur in the A-frame. Basically, the crack occur in the stiffening ribs and the change in the cross section area, which will be act as a stress reserve. Now, as you can see, crack in the frame occur at sharp change in section, welded joint, edge preparation, and also near the stiffening member between the A-frame and the guide plate, as shown in the figure. Okay, so as you can see here, means this is a crack which has been occurred. Okay, and now this is a guide plate, this is a stiffening member, as you can see in this diagram. So basically what I mean to say that the sharp change in cross section area mainly occur in the guide area. Also means suppose this welding may go haywire, means the welding penetration is not good enough, and therefore after a specific running period of time, it may under due to vibration, it may break down. So timely inspection is need to be carried out to make sure that the bed plate and the A-frame structure are crack free. Okay, now let's see what are the rectification of the A-frame which we can carry if we found a crack. So as you can see in this diagram, this is called ear solution repair. What is the ear solution repair? Removing the affected area by cutting the affected area, then doing the grinding and welding of the stiffening rib. After accurately locating the end of the repair correctly, drilling of the hole can be used as a temporary repair. So what we are doing, as you can see, suppose the crack has occurred here. So what we are doing, we are, as if we remove, if we keep it here, ultimately it will propagate and it can damage the whole thing. So one, what we are doing, we are cutting that part. Okay, we are cutting that part so that the crack cannot propagate and the whole thing can be eliminated. And another method is that if suppose a small crack has occurred here, so what we can do, we can follow the drilling insert repair method. What we used to do means, in that case, first we drill to the extension of the crack. Okay, and after that we insert the tube, and then the tube will seal the crack, and then it will be broken off, and again it will be grinded. So this will provide additional strength to the structure and will prevent the propagation of the crack, and we need to timely monitor it, and if it is still persists, in that case we have to carry out the repair in the dry dock. Okay friend, I hope you have understand the video. Please do like and subscribe my video. Thank you. It's a request to all of you, please do subscribe and like my video so that you keep an update, and please subscribe. Please, thank you friend. Hope you like this.